I have already mentioned about relative extremum value. Now the similar thing, one more is nothing but absolute extremum. So similarly, when we explained relative extremum, it had relative maximum value and the relative minimum value. Same way, when I'm going to say absolute extremum, even that has an absolute maximum value and also the absolute minimum value. Now the question arises, what is absolute maximum value and what is absolute minimum value? Okay. Absolute maximum value is nothing but if I get a point C in the interval such that f of x is less than or equal to f of C, then I can say that this is nothing but absolute maximum value. If I get f of x greater than or equal to f of C, then this is nothing but absolute minimum value. Now the question arises, the same definition was set for relative maximum value as well as relative minimum value. So what is the difference between these two? So I'll use a graph to explain it better. Suppose I have a graph. This way. Think that, see here, the graph is increasing. When we say that the graph is increasing, suppose this is a point for x1 and this is a point x2. When I say that the graph is an increasing graph, if I get x1 greater than x2, clearly x1 less than x2, if the function value, that is f of x1, is also less than f of x2, then I can say that the graph is increasing graph. Suppose the reverse case happens, that is I take two points x1 less than x2. Suppose I get f of x1 greater than f of x2, then that graph is a decreasing function. So this graph is increasing, then I get a decreasing graph. So I get a turning point here where the graph, increasing graph turns to decreasing graph. So that point is nothing but the critical point. Okay, coming to our topic, that is absolute maximum and absolute minimum value. See here, the value is attaining the maximum value here. So this value, I can also say that relative maximum. Here the value is minimum, so I can say that this is a relative minimum value. Then once again the graph attains the minimum value here, so this is also relative minimum. Next it attains the maximum value, this is also relative maximum. This is attaining the once again the minimum value, relative minimum. So on I can continue. But what is absolute maximum and absolute minimum value? See, in throughout the graph, where the graph attains the minimum value, that is nothing but the absolute minimum value. Where the graph attains the maximum value, that is nothing but the absolute maximum value. So here, this value of the, this is relative maximum value. This is the relative minimum value. See here, relative maximum value is less than the relative minimum value. But we are considering this as a relative maximum value in this interval. In this interval. This is a relative minimum value in this interval. But absolute maximum and absolute minimum we are considering in the graph, which is the maximum value, that is the absolute maximum. Which is the minimum value, that is the absolute minimum value. So if the graph has absolute maximum or the absolute minimum value, then we say that it is having the absolute extremum value. Here comes one more theorem, that is extreme value theorem. What extreme value theorem says? Extreme value theorem says that if the function is continuous, if I have a function f, if that function is continuous, then it will have absolute maximum value as well as absolute minimum value. Okay, now we will move on to the next theorem, that is based on this concept, that is nothing but the Rolle's theorem. What does Rolle's theorem says? Rolle's theorem says that f, I'll consider as a function. Okay, if f is a function, first condition is f is continuous in the closed interval a comma b. Second condition says that f is differentiable in open interval a comma b. And third condition says that f of a is equal to 0 and f of b is equal to 0. If these three conditions satisfies, then I can find a c belongs to open interval a comma b such that f dash of c is equal to 0. So here they have already given that it is continuous. They have also given that it is differentiable. They have given that the points f of a is equal to 0 and f of b is equal to 0. So in they are saying that you can find a point c such that f dash of c is equal to 0. Now here again two cases arises, that is they are given f of a is equal to 0, f of b is equal to 0. In between I can find some points x, limit as x. So all the values of x may be equal to 0. All the values of that function values at that points x may not be 0. Some may be 0, some may not be 0. Or all the points function values may be 0. So I'll consider case 1 as f of x is equal to 0. So it is given that it is continuous, it is differentiable. So clearly I can write f dash of x is also equal to 0. So I can directly write that I can find a point c belongs to a comma open interval a comma b such that f dash of c is equal to 0. So the if all the points are equal to 0, then we can obtain a point c belongs to function values is equal to 0, then we can find a point c belongs to a comma b such that f dash of c is equal to 0. Now the second case arises, that is case 2. Suppose f of x is not equal to 0, so for some values x. So in this case, how we can prove that the f dash of c is equal to 0? Think about that, we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.